In this tutorial, I'll be showing you a step-by-step how to create a stunning social media overlay for your YouTube videos. That'll help you stand out from the crowd and increase engagement with your audience. Hey guys, my name is RJ Martinez, and in this video, we'll be talking about how to make social media overlays with your YouTube videos with Canva. If you're a content creator that wants to make your content more engaging and interactive, then this tutorial is for you. Before we get started, let's talk about how social media overlays are very important for your videos. Social media overlays are a great way to showcase your social media handles, promote your content, and create a better experience for your viewer. By adding social media overlays to your videos, you can increase the engagement, grow your social media following, and create a stronger brand identity.
All right, so if you guys are unaware, what is Canva? Okay, Canva is basically an online design tool, okay? And they have a ton of templates back there, drag and drop, and you can post on social media too as well. So you can post your content through Canva, and they have a ton of like awesome features from different elements, the templates, just everything you can possibly think of. Okay, so it's an awesome tool, and it's you can use it for free. They have like a 7-day trial or 14-day trial for the Canva Pro. And then obviously one of the cool things that I personally like to do is link this to my team. Okay, I outsource a lot of stuff for my business to, you know, help, obviously helping me my business grow. So I always outsource little things that I can do within my business to help perform and be more productive at the level I want to be. And Canva is an awesome tool to use as far as, you know, creating social media content, creating thumbnails, creating, you know, overlays of what I'm going to show you in this video, and creating social different types of social media posts, and even designing like t-shirts, stuff like that. All right, so I'm signed in over here to my Canva account. And what we're gonna do is, like I said, create a social media overlay. So what we're gonna do is come over, create a design. So let's say if you wanna create certain things, like you can do the search bar right here. It's gonna basically show you all the different types of templates that you can use over here. Okay, YouTube display ad, YouTube channel, YouTube banner, live stream video, okay, YouTube profile, shorts, thumbnail, video chapters, and the list of YouTube fitness, YouTube banner, so on and so forth. So you can see right here, it says 300 by 60 pixels. Okay, so if we click on this, right, we come over here, it's basically gonna create the template for us for our overlay, right? Which is really, really awesome because you can do a lot with this right here. So even with these templates, right, you want to come in here and add a template, right? And you can create a simple one, say promo only valid today, get it now, our new earphone 30%. Okay, so let's say get it now, new ebook. Okay, let's say ebook. Let's say we want to use this one for an example, right? We switch a little things up inside of here. We're use the, let's say 50%, right, promo about only today, getting discount up to 50%. Okay, boom, let's say we want to use this one. So we're already, and there's a few different ones inside of here that you can use as a template, but we'll go ahead and we'll test one out, like this one of the templates, and then I will personally create one to show you exactly, like say for a social media handle, let's say you follow you on TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, whatever it is, and basically you'll repeat that same process for every single social media handle, right? But this one, to say we're cool with this one, we like this one, we're gonna go ahead and PNG. Okay, we're gonna leave it a PNG, leave it as is, and we're gonna hit download. Okay, so we downloaded that onto the computer, right? It's downloading, boom, done. Okay, your downloads go to, right? That's up to you, you go from there. So we have one created, right? And then we're gonna go ahead and create one from scratch. So we're gonna just basically, you can see how easy this is. I can just delete everything right there, right? Now on the left-hand column, let's say like select an element. You can see obviously I recently created one with the Instagram, but we'll go ahead and we'll do a TikTok one, right? So I'll put this element inside of here. Let's see why is this? Okay, let me go ahead and let's redo this all over. Let's go back. Undo everything. Let's go back from the beginning right there. Okay, so I went back to the very beginning where it was blank, and I'm just gonna go ahead and drag and drop. Okay, me dragging and dropping in here is bringing this in to what we want to do. Okay, so let's say we want to take up, let's say let's try this out, take up this space right here, but we're gonna leave a little part of it blank right here. Let's say we're gonna add in our TikTok logo, and we're gonna type that in up here. And there's a ton of stuff you can do. Remember, you can upload your own logo. You can put in your like different text. So there's different text that you can go into here. There's just a ton that can be done in here. Okay, so we're going to elements. We got the logo right there. You can even just use the TikTok or this logo. Let's see that one. Yeah. Okay. Well, okay. This also too. So this we can do. Messing with this. This is the background color, right? We can change the background color. Let's just do it all black. Okay. For this example, come back over here. Take that TikTok logo, right? Just going to make it big. Nice and big so you can see it. Okay. Boom. Nice. We got the TikTok logo going. Even that one too. Like if you even like this one, it's real simple. You just grab this one. You can see how I'm dragging and just, you know, expanding it, making it bigger, right? And so if you don't like the certain logo, you didn't like that one. We didn't like that one. I said we wanted to make sure they see that it says TikTok. And you can see how I'm dragging it, right? And it's putting it in place to how we want it to be, right? Which is really cool. You can do a lot with this. It's really, really cool. Let's bring it over a little bit over. Then we're going to come over here to text. We can put it in, like when you put in your, like you said, we put in your text right here. Don't worry about that. You just add a heading, right? And then you can edit any of the font text that you want to edit inside of here. Okay. There's a ton of different fonts you can choose from. Okay. So let's say I'm making it for my personal social RJ Hustles, right? I'm forgetting the H in there. I can't forget the H in Hustles, right? So we have RJ Hustles, right? Let me put the capitalized J right there. So we got RJ Hustles. And then I'm just going to expand this right here to make it even bigger, right? Which is really cool. And let's say I wanted to add like a little dash right here at the beginning. Dash. I don't like that dash. Let's put RJ Hustles. Okay. Boom. Make it look nice and pretty and big. Make this a little bit bigger. Boom. Okay. Like it. Looking good. Decent. I'm going to say I want to switch the font up right here on this one, right? Go up to Code Pro. Let's use that font right there. Okay. And I think it looks pretty good. Looks good. Okay. So we're good. We're happy with that. I'm going to go ahead and download this. Okay. Boom. We got it downloaded. And I can literally, let's say I want to add another page. Okay. So to like duplicate this, I can even duplicate it, right? Let's say I want to duplicate it. Like, let's say the whole thing, I want to duplicate the whole thing. You can literally just duplicate the whole thing, change this out, right? Let's say like YouTube, let's say YouTube. Elements up here. That's already elements. Logo, right? Logo. Hit the logo. Okay, we want to take this out and we want to add this one in here, right? It's literally that simple. Okay, it's that simple to do that. Now, let's say we're cool with that. Let's make sure we're lined up correctly here. Okay, I think we're good. Okay, we're happy with that. And we can download this one too as well. Download page two. Okay, just want page two because we downloaded the first one already, right? So it's downloading page two. Okay, now I'm going to come over here. So we have these icons. I'm going to come over here to a video that I haven't even messed with yet, but we're going to go ahead and just add these into. So it doesn't matter what type of video editing software that you're using. You can use any type of video editing software. I'm using Wondershare Filmora. And basically what I'm going to do is grab those three overlays we created, right? And just drag and drop them in here. Okay. And you can see that I'm bringing it in here, right? And I'm going to make it a little smaller. So as I make it a little smaller, it's going to be, you know, it looks a little pixelated when I brought it up. You maybe want to mess with the pixels, right? You may be a little bit bigger, but as we get it smaller, it looks better, right? You can see that. So for example, let's go. We have this already in there, right? We have one of the overlays that popped into there. And so we want to put it here. Okay. And then it goes over to the next one. We'll do the same exact thing. Okay, bring it to there. And then the same exact thing with this one, make it a little smaller and bring it to there, right? And then with inside here too, you can mess with like, you know, you can mess with like a image, you can mess with the animation. So if I hit that, you can see how that works out right there. And then the next one, let's say I want to do a different animation for that one. And then this one, I do want to do that one too as well. Okay, so let's say, you know, the daily, as I'm talking, like the daily video's playing.
Categories and what shirts are making sales right now. And you can use this for Amazon merch on demand. Redbubble or Etsy or whatever print on demand platform you're selling on. Okay, so
you see how that overlay can work, and then you just mess with this how the way you would like it. And maybe instead of like, because, and maybe instead of the default, come back over here at the default. I think it's where's the pixel at for this thing? Should show it here. So I think the default, if we come back over here, the default shows are 300 by 60 pixels. So maybe we do a custom one. You can do a custom one, which would be, you can do like 300 by 100, right? And that may, you know, make it a little bit better and less pixelated when it comes to that, okay? And you're messing with the pixels right there and just trying to make it human. That way it's not blurry. But as you bring it down, you can see how it looks, which looks really cool. Let's go ahead and try it one more time. Boom. And then also to another cool thing too is don't forget to, as you're doing certain things, you can, you know, add in like a sound. When you add in a sound too, it kind of gets the viewer's attention, right? And when it makes a little sound, it gets the viewer's attention. So don't forget, like if you're doing any type of image or anything like that, put like some type of little swish or a little sound. And most of these video editing softwares come with it for free. Okay. And they're free for commercial use. So make sure that you got use little sounds as you're doing, you know, your images and stuff on the screen. And that's how you would do that, right? Which is really awesome. And then in return, you create more brand awareness. You'll get more followers on social media too as well.
That's it. By following these simple steps, you can create social media overlays for your YouTube videos using Canva. Remember, social media overlays are a great way to increase the engagement with your audience, promote your content, and create stronger brand identity. So what are you waiting for? Start creating your social media overlays today and take your YouTube videos to that next level.